Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways, lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun in our eyes, behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, who will give him life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. O clap your hands together, all you peoples, and cry aloud unto God with shouts of joy. For the Lord Most High is to be feared. He is the great King over all the earth. He shall subdue the peoples under us and the nations under our feet. He shall choose our inheritance for us, the pride of Jacob, whom he loved. God has gone up with a shout of triumph, the Lord with the sound of the trumpet. O sing praises unto our God. O sing praises unto our King. For God is the King of all the earth. Think upon his mighty acts and praise him with a song. God reigns over the nations. God sits on his holy throne. The princes of the peoples are gathered with the people of God, of the God of Abraham. For the mighty upon earth have become the servants of the Lord, and he is very highly exalted. Great is the Lord, and highly to be praised in the city of our God, even upon this holy hill. The hill of Zion is beautiful and lofty. It is the joy of the whole earth. Upon the north side lies the city of the great King. God is well known in her palaces as a sure refuge. For behold, the kings of the earth have gathered and advanced together. They marveled to see such things. They were astonished and fled in terror. Trembling came upon them in anguish as a woman in travail. You caused the east wind to blow and broke apart the ships of Tarshish. As we have heard, so have we seen in the city of the Lord of hosts, in the city of our God. God upholds her forever. We wait for your loving kindness, O God, in the midst of your temple. O God, according to your name, so is your praise to the world's end. Your right hand is full of righteousness. Let Mount Zion rejoice, and the cities of Judah be glad because of your judgments. Walk about Zion and go round about her. Count the number of her towers. Mark well her bulwarks. Consider her strongholds, that you may tell those who come after. This God is our God forever and ever. He shall be our guide even unto death. Hear this, all you peoples. Ponder it with your ears. All who dwell in the world, high and low, rich and poor, everyone with his neighbor, my mouth shall speak of wisdom, and my heart shall muse on understanding. I will incline my ear to a parable and declare my dark sayings with the harp. Why should I fear in the days of wickedness, and when the wicked at my heels can compass me round about? There are some who put their trust in their goods and boast in the multitude of their riches, but no one can deliver his brother, nor pay unto God a price for him. For it is so costly to redeem their souls that we should never have enough to pay it, so that they should live forever and should not see the grave. For we see that wise men die as well as the ignorant and foolish. They perish alike and leave their riches for others. And yet they think that their houses shall continue forever, and that their dwelling places shall endure from one generation to another. And yet you think that their houses shall continue forever, and that their dwelling places shall endure from one generation to another. And they call lands after their own names. Man is like an ox that has no understanding. He is like the beasts that perish. This is the way of their foolishness, yet their posterity praise their sins. Like sheep, they are appointed to die, and death shall be their shepherd. They shall go down straight into the sepulchre. Their beauty shall consume away in the grave, which shall be their dwelling place forever. But God shall save me from the power of death, for he shall deliver my soul. Be not envious if one is made rich, or if the glory of his house is increased, for he shall carry nothing away with him when he dies, neither shall his glory follow him. For while he lived, he counted himself happy, and so long as he did well for himself, people spoke well of him. He shall follow the generation of his fathers and shall never see the light. Those who are honored but have no understanding are like the beasts that perish. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Jeremiah, beginning with the 8th chapter, the first verse. At that time declares the Lord, the bones of the kings of Judah, the bones of its officials, the bones of the priests, the bones of the prophets, and the bones of the inhabitants of Jerusalem shall be brought out of their tombs, and they shall be spread before the sun and the moon and all the host of heaven, which they have loved and served, which they have gone after, and which they have sought and worshipped, and they shall not be gathered or buried. They shall be as dung on the face of the ground. Death shall be preferred to life by all the remnant that remains of this evil family in all the places where I have driven them, declares the Lord of hosts. You shall say to them, thus says the Lord, when men fall, do they not rise again? If one turns away, does he not return? Why then has this people turned away in perpetual backsliding? They hold fast to deceit. They refuse to return. I have paid attention and listened, but they have not spoken rightly. No man relents of his evil, saying, what have I done? Everyone turns to his own course, like a horse plunging headlong into battle. Even the stork in the heavens know her times, and the turtle dove, swallow, crane keep the time of their coming, but my people know not the rules of the Lord. How can you say we are wise and that the law of the Lord is with us? But behold, the lying pen of the scribes has made it into a lie. The wise men shall be put to shame. They shall be dismayed and taken. Behold, they have rejected the word of the Lord, so what wisdom is in them? Therefore I will give their wives to others and their fields to conquerors, because from the least to the greatest, everyone is greedy for unjust gain. From prophet to priest, everyone deals falsely. They have healed the wound of my people lightly, saying, peace, peace, when there is no peace. Were they ashamed when they committed abomination? No, they were not at all ashamed. They did not know how to blush, therefore they shall fall among the fallen. When I punish them, they shall be overthrown, says the Lord. When I would gather them, declares the Lord, there are no grapes on the vine, no figs on the fig tree, even the leaves are withered, and what I gave them has passed away from them. Why do we sit still, gather together? Let us go into the fortified cities and perish there, for the Lord our God has doomed us to perish and has given us poisoned water to drink, because we have sinned against the Lord. We looked for peace, but no good came, for a time of healing, but behold, terror. The snorting of their horses is heard from Dan. At the sound of the neigh of their stallions, the whole land quakes. They come and devour the land and all that fills it, the city and those who dwell in it. For behold, I am sending among you serpents, adders that cannot be charmed, and they shall bite you, declares the Lord. My joy is gone, grief is upon me, my heart is sick within me. Behold, the cry of the daughter of my people from the length and breadth of the land. Is the Lord not in Zion? Is her king not in her? Why have they provoked me to anger with their carved images and with their foreign idols? The harvest is past, the summer is ended, and we are not saved. For the wound of the daughter of my people is my heart. For the wound of the daughter of my people is my heart wounded. I mourn and dismay. And dismay has taken hold of me. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then has the health of the daughter of my people not been restored? This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I will sing to the Lord, for he is lofty and uplifted. The horse and its rider he has hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my refuge. The Lord has become my Savior. This is my God, and I will praise him. The God of my people, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a mighty warrior. The Lord is his name. The chariots of Pharaoh and his army. Yet he has hurled into the sea. The finest of those who bear armor have been drowned in the Red Sea. The fathomless deep has overwhelmed them. They sank into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, is glorious in might. Your right hand, O Lord, has overthrown the enemy. Who can be compared with you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, awesome in renown, and worker of wonders? You stretched forth your right hand, the earth swallowed them up. With your constant love, you led the people you redeemed. You brought them in safety to your holy dwelling. You will bring them in and plant them on the mount of your possession, the resting place you have made for yourself, O Lord, the sanctuary, O Lord, that your hand has established. The Lord shall reign forever and forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from St. Paul's first epistle to the Thessalonians, beginning with the second chapter, the first verse. For you yourselves know, brothers, that our coming to you was not in vain, but though we had already suffered and been shamefully treated at Philippi, as you know, we had boldness in our God to declare to you the gospel of God in the midst of much conflict, for our appeal does not spring from error or impurity or any attempt to deceive, but just as we have been approved by God to be entrusted with the gospel. So we speak not to please man, but to please God who tests our hearts. For we never came with words of flattery, as you know, nor with a pretext for greed, God is witness, nor did we seek glory from God, whether from you or from others, though we could have made demands as apostles of Christ. But we were gentle among you, like a nursing mother taking care of her own children. So, being affectionately desirous of you, we were ready to share with you not only the gospel of God, but also our own selves, because you have become very dear to us. For you remember, brothers, our labor and toil. We worked night and day, as we might not be a burden to any of you, while we proclaim to you the gospel of God. You are witnesses in God also. How holy and righteous and blameless was our conduct toward you believers. For you know how, like a father with his children, we exhorted each one of you and encouraged you and charged you to walk in a manner worthy of God, who calls you into his own kingdom and glory. And we also thank God constantly for this, that when you received the word of God, which you heard from us, you accepted it not as the word of men, but as what it really is, the word of God, which is at work in you believers. For you, brothers, became imitators of the churches of God in Christ Jesus that are in Judea, for you suffered the same things from your own countrymen, as they did from the Jews, who killed both the Lord Jesus and the prophets and drove us out, and displeased God and oppose all mankind by hindering us from speaking to the Gentiles that they might be saved, so as always to fill up the measure of their sins. But wrath has come upon them at last. This is the word of the Lord. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. We entreat you, O Lord.
To your holy angels, to lead us in paths of peace and goodwill.
We entreat you, O Lord.
That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses.
We entreat you, O Lord. We entreat you, O Lord.
That we may depart this life in faith and fear, not in the day of the great judgment seat of Christ.
We entreat you, O Lord.
Eternal Father, at the baptism of Jesus, you revealed in him to be your Son, and your Holy Spirit descended upon him like a dove, and that we were born again by water and the Spirit, maybe faithful as your adopted children.
Amen.
O God, the source of all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works, give to your servants a peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set away at the limits, and that we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and the hope of glory. And we pray. Give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your grace, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace in this time, one accord to make our constant petitions, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son, who is with Mary gathered together, this may be a part of your past, the founder of our present society, and petitions as may be less for us, granting us in this world the light of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May God of hope fill us with all joy and keep believing through the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Yeah.